Hi everyone, in this video I'll show you how to get started with building a graphical user interface, or GUI for short, in Java. To build our GUI, we will be using the Abstract Window Toolkit, or AWT for short, and the Swing Toolkit. These are already part of the Java standard library, so we just have to import the appropriate classes in order to be able to use them. The AWT and Swing packages will allow us to do things such as create windows and panels, buttons and text fields, and make things respond to events such as clicks and mouse overs, among other things. Let's start with the Swing Toolkit. So I have a class here that I've called TestFrame. I'll go up here and I'll type import javax.swing.jframe in order to import the Swing Toolkit's JFrame class. The JFrame class will let us create a window for our Java application. Next, we will make our class inherit from the JFrame class by adding extends JFrame here in our class declaration. So now, instances of our TestFrame class will inherit the public members of the JFrame class. Some examples of these inherited members are methods that will allow us to do things like set the size of our frame and set a title for it. So now I'll be adding two integer fields to this class, one to store the width and another to store the height of the JFrame. And then let's create the constructor. Let's give two parameters so that we can pass to it the desired width and height for the JFrame. And then we will assign those values to our width and height fields. Next, I'll create a custom method that will set up the GUI. I could actually put all of the succeeding code here in the constructor, but I'd prefer to create a custom method just to keep things more organized. For this method, I'll say public void and I'll call it setup GUI. The first thing I'll do here is I will set the size of the JFrame. To do that, I will use the setSize method. There's no need for us to define this method anymore, because it's already been inherited by extending the JFrame class, so we can use it right away. The way the setSize method works is you pass to it two integers. The first one will be for the width of the window, and the second one will be for the height. I'm just going to pass the width and the height fields. Whatever values they have will be the width and height of the window. After that, I'll add a title to my JFrame by using the setTitle method. This one accepts a string, which will be displayed in the JFrame's title bar. So I'll just say my Java app. After that, I'll type setDefaultClose JFrame.exitOnClose. This line states that when the user closes the window, then the application will exit. Another option, such as hideOnClose, will just hide the window and keep the application running. But let's use exitOnClose for this one. And then finally, we have to show the window by invoking the setVisible method and giving it a value of true. This usually comes at the end, because you want to set the other things first before you set the visibility to true. So all of these methods that we just used are accessible in this class because we extended the JFrame class. If we did not do that, then we won't be able to use these methods. So now let's go ahead and test our JFrame to see if it will show up. To create a new test frame, we call our test frame constructor, and we will pass to it our desired width and height. And then we will call this custom method that we made, which we've named setup GUI, in order to make the window come out. So let's go ahead and do that here in the main method of the tester class. I'll say test frame F is equal to new test frame 640,480. This will create a new instance of our TestFrame class, which we can reference using this variable f. We've set the width to 640 and the height to 480. And then Let's call our custom method named setupGUI by saying f.setupGUI. So let's run our app, and here we see our window. In the next video, we'll add a big button here inside the window, and we'll make it print out a message in the output window every time the button is clicked.